At this point, you should have a conceptual idea of what the mathematical model is that ANSYS is solving in this particular wind turbine blade case. And we understood this mathematical model by analogy to the Euler-Bernoulli beam theory. Next, let's take a look at how ANSYS is going to solve that mathematical model numerically. And again, we are going to understand that by analogy to the Euler-Bernoulli beam theory. So if I go to what's under the black box framework, I'm moving from talking about the mathematical model, and in that case, we are focusing on the key physical principles and assumptions. So we've done that, and let's move on to thinking about the numerical solution strategy for that mathematical model. First, let's review the numerical solution strategy for beam theory, which is considered in the cantilever beam module. So essentially, we need to find the deform shape of the midline here, that is this function, such that the potential energy of the beam is minimized. And we say, you know what? It's too hard to find an unknown function. So instead, we will find values at selected points, in this case, three points, three nodes. And we determine the transverse displacements there. And it turns out we also have to, you know, calculate the rotations of the cross sections at that locations, because the rotation is related to the slope. And if we don't, you know, if we don't calculate the rotations, then it means that the slope can be discontinuous, which means that you can have two rotations of the cross section at the same location, and you know, you get this non-physical behavior. So that's why this is key. And then once we know these values, we can interpolate, you know, or in terms of these values, we can interpolate to find the value anywhere in between. So through an interpolation, you know, you can construct. So let's say if this is this value, so this would be constructed through an interpolation like that, okay? And then you'll have another interpolation in this region, and so on. So you have to interpolate in between the nodes. And then once you have that interpolation, that means that, you know, you can find how any point on the cross section is going to move in terms of these values. You don't know those values yet, but if I knew those values, I can calculate, you know, how much each point would move, and from that I can calculate strains. Given material properties, I can calculate stresses, and from that I can calculate the potential energy. So essentially, you know, in terms of these values, I can calculate the potential energy, and then the answers would generate the algebraic equations required to, you know, by minimization of the potential energy or from the boundary conditions. How do you extend that idea to shell theory? Okay, so here I have the Euler-Bernoulli framework, and if I go to shell theory, now instead of having to find the deformed midline, I need to find the deformed shape of that, and I'll say, you know what, I'm going to find it, you know, finding a deformed two-dimensional function, deformed shape is really hard, such that, you know, by minimizing the potential energy, instead I could do something more tractable, that is find values at selected points. And let's say I pick these as my selected points. So let's say I have 9 points at which I'll say I'll find the displacements. And by analogy to here, you also need to find the rotations. If this is node 2, okay, you need to find, and if that's x, y, and z as before, so you need to find how much it's going to deform, how much that point is going to move normal to the mid-surface, so that's going to be uz2. It could also move along the plane in x and y directions, and then you have the rotation of the normal in, you know, about the y-axis, about the x-axis, and you could also have an in-plane rotation. So you'll have three displacements and three rotations to find at each node. And so we have six, you know, you'd say 6 degrees of freedom per node, and you have 9 nodes equals 54 total degrees of freedom. And in between, right, so I'm determining stuff here in between. You know, if I want to find the value here, I would do an interpolation of these four values. So, you know, interpolation in this region would be between these four values, and interpolation in this region would be between these four values, and so on. So it's going to be an, you know, what would we call an element by element interpolation, and from that I can construct the deformed shape. So the deformed shape would be constructed in terms of four interpolations here, because we have four elements. So the problem reduces to determining these values, these 54 values, such that the potential energy of the beam is minimized, but also the essential or the displacement boundary conditions or displacement rotation boundary conditions are satisfied. Let's take a look at that next.